Some facts about the digestive system. Number one, the digestive system includes 10 organs. Before you even take your first bite of food, your salivary glands start producing enzyme-rich saliva in anticipation of the starches your body will need to break down. These glands are the first organs involved in the digestive system. A complicated network of 10 organs that span the entire length of your torso. Other organs involved include the pharynx, throat, esophagus, stomach, liver, gallbladder, pancreas, small intestine, large intestine, and rectum. Number two, your digestive system has its own nervous system. The digestive process is controlled by the enteric nervous system, which functions independently of the brain but contains some of the same types of neurons and neurotransmitters. In fact, there are so many of these neurons in the gastrointestinal tract that we think there are about as many neurons as there are in our spinal cord, says Jeffrey A. Priedes, a scientific advisory board member of the American Gastroenterological Association Center for Gut Microbiome Research and Education. Often called the body's second brain, the enteric nervous system is capable of sensing the food you eat, producing hormones like serotonin, and controlling your gut muscles, to name just a couple of its functions. Some of these sensory nerves can even tell the brain when it's time to lay off the cheese fries. If we are bloated, those nerves can tell us, hey, this is a distended stomach or distended intestine, and it can signal pain or discomfort back up to the brain, Priedes says. Number three, the digestive system feels when you're nervous or stressed. This second brain also might explain why stress and anxiety can wreak havoc on one's digestive system, at times causing butterflies in your belly or more malicious symptoms. I think everybody can envision a circumstance in their own personal life in which there's been a really stressful situation and they've experienced some sort of gastrointestinal symptom, whether that is pain or a change in their bowel habits, Priedes says. Some people will be more sensitive to pain and some will need to run to the restroom more frequently. So it's very individualized. When a fight or flight response is triggered in the brain, it can also cause digestion to slow or even come to a halt, allowing your body to instead focus on whatever threat you're facing. It's unclear what exactly causes these gastrointestinal reactions to stress though. A recent study in mice revealed that a specialist diet could alter their gut microbiome, thereby changing their brain chemicals and influencing their response to stress. Of course, rodents are not people, and no one is rushing out to make recommendations for patients with stress or anxiety, says Priedes, who was not involved in that study. But this could potentially drive clinical trials of that nature in the future. You don't really have to wait 30 minutes to swim after eating. This belief held that after a big meal, blood was diverted to the body's core and away from the limbs, which weakened your arms, legs, and increased the risk of drowning. The old wives' tale has long been scaring children and adults into sitting beside the pool while waiting for their lunch to digest. Well, we have some good news for you. It isn't based in fact. While eating does divert some blood flow from the muscles to the digestive tract, it isn't enough of a change to render your arms and legs immobile in the water. At most, you might get a minor cramp. Ancient Greeks and Romans often ate lying down. That isn't recommended for people today. Dining while reclining was seen as a power play in ancient Greece and Rome. It was then that someone, typically a man, had the luxury of lounging around and eating to his heart's content while someone else served him. The social customs in Greece dictated that women should eat sitting up, but some upper-class women in ancient Rome feasted in a supine position as well. As James Brown, a biology lecturer at Aston University in Birmingham, UK, writes for The Conversation, lying on one's left side can reduce pressure on the lower stomach, allowing one to pig out more comfortably. It may also allow carbohydrates to be absorbed more slowly, and therefore prevent spikes in insulin levels, but that's pretty much where the benefits end. It could also lead to an increased risk of gastroesophageal reflux disease, or GERD, and the American College of Gastroenterology recommends that people avoid lying down for 2 hours after eating. Digestive system functions don't have anything to do with gravity. Though experts warn against eating while lying down, this suggestion isn't related to gravitational force. That's because digestion is aided not by physics but by peristalsis, the contracting of muscles along the digestive tract to transport food through the body. It explains why astronauts are still able to digest their freeze-dried space spaghetti in zero-gravity conditions. Last fact. Digestive systems vary greatly from one species to the next. While animals like cows, deer, and giraffes have four-chambered stomachs, other animals including seahorses, chimeras, and platypuses have no stomach at all. In the case of platypuses, food travels from the esophagus directly to the intestines. As for seahorses, they are almost constantly wolfing down brine shrimp, often 3,000 or more per day, because the digestive process happens so quickly. On the flip side of that, sloths have one of the slowest digestive systems. It can take a month for their stomachs to digest a single meal, which explains why they try to conserve energy by moving as little as possible. It's not laziness, it's a survival tactic.